So our study looked at sleep quality, which is basically people who are in bed, but their sleep may be very choppy, or they can't quite fall asleep. They can't reach, they're awake and then they fall asleep again, then they're awake. So again, poor quality of sleep. That was the characteristic that we were looking at here in our patients. And previous work has shown, in fact, that sleep fragmentation, this form of choppy sleep, in fact, is associated with the risk of cognitive decline, with Alzheimer's disease, and so on. So our work in patients with stroke and TIA is really an extension of that, where we see that, in fact, poor quality of sleep here, the sleep fragmentation is also associated here with these enlarged perivascular spaces, these spaces around the brain, around the blood vessels of the brain. And our work puts in context kind of some of the previous work, and that why sleep fragmentation has been shown to be poor for one's health may very well be that the brain toxins can't clear well, and that as a result is enlarging these perivascular spaces.
The brain is a highly metabolic organ. There's a lot of activity going on in the brain. However, it doesn't have the same clearance mechanisms that the rest of the body has. Our research wanted to really look at how the brain gets rid of all of these toxic chemicals, and it appears that it does occur during sleep, and it appears to occur through the perivascular space. So these are two patients that we included in our study. This patient here was a patient with relatively poor sleep. They only slept about 3 hours in the sleep lab, and they have quite a few of these black spots here. These are the perivascular spaces that have become enlarged. This patient here is another patient that had relatively good sleep. They slept about 6 hours in the sleep lab, and you can see that their brain is relatively clear of these enlarged perivascular spaces.
I think the implications at this time for patients would be that if you do have a sleep problem, you should see a specialist or at least your family doctor about trying to improve your sleep quality. So there's a lot of things that could be done right now, such as treating sleep apnea. If you have limb movements in your sleep, those are often very treatable as well. And other forms of sleep fragmentation also, through things like good sleep hygiene, can also really, really, really help a lot. So all these things are, our research is showing now that it's just, if you're not sleeping well, don't just attribute it to your age or to your underlying health condition. It's always a really good idea to really get these things checked out, because they may have over the years long-term implications for your overall health.